The armed forces are drawing up the final contours of theatrization plans, which seek to integrate the Army, Navy and the Indian Air Force and their resources into specific theater commands. While late General Rawat's initial plan was to create 4 theater commands, the services decided to take a fresh look at the proposed reform after General Chauhan asked them to do so. One of the top proposals being considered is to create joint theater commands based on India's adversaries in the neighborhood to begin with, as against the 4 defined theater commands planned earlier. This involves initially carving out an integrated theater command to take care of the northern and eastern borders with China, another for the western borders with Pakistan, and a 3rd maritime command to tackle threats in the maritime domain from the 17 service-specific military commands operating under the 3 services at present. Visakhapatnam, Jaipur, and Lucknow are among the possible locations being discussed for their headquarters. Also under discussion is the creation of a joint training command. 3 joint logistics nodes had already been operationalized until 2021. India has 2 joint services commands at present, the Andaman and Nicobar Command and the Strategic Forces Command. Threats emanating from China, Pakistan, and via the sea routes are being factored into the plans for theater commands. A national security strategy essentially outlines the path that a country should take to realize its national objectives and interests. The lack of such a strategy has been a subject of discussion within the strategic community for years. The plan for theaterization of armed forces or creation of integrated theater commands, which was spearheaded by the country's first chief of defense staff, General Bipin Rawat, came to a creaking halt after his death in a helicopter crash days before the 2022 New Year. Now, with a few changes, the plan is being fine-tuned for implementation. Integrated theater commands are war-fighting entities containing Army, Navy, and Air Force components that would fight jointly to focus and synergize the combat power of all 3 services, a much-needed security adrenaline that pundits have demanded for a long time. The need to swiftly implement this plan in light of tensions with China and Pakistan was aided in no small measure by the former Army Chief General Manoj Mukund Narwane, who told a memorial lecture in the last week of December 2022 that framing a national security strategy was a prerequisite for taking theatrization forward to optimally utilize the military's resources for future wars and operations. Without such a well-defined strategy, pursuing the long-awaited reform would be akin to putting the cart before the horse, he said. A rare testy line from a former head of the military. The armed forces currently have 17 single service commands spread across the country. The Army and Air Force have 7 commands each, while the Navy has 3. The Army is divided into 6 operational commands and 1 training command each, under the command of a Lieutenant General who has an equal status to the Vice Chief of Army Staff, working under the control of Army Headquarters in New Delhi. Of the Indian Air Force's 7 commands, 5 are operational commands and 2 are functional commands. The Indian Navy currently operates 3 commands: Western Naval Command, located at Mumbai; Southern Naval Command, located at Kochi; and Eastern Naval Command, located at Visakhapatnam. Traditionally, multiple commands have determined India's war strategy. For instance, today 4 different army commands look after Pakistan: Northern, Western, Southwestern, and Southern commands. The Air Force has 3 commands looking after the frontier, while the Navy has 2. The frontier with China is managed by a similarly multiplicity of commands. The Central Air Command, located in Allahabad, has a role in managing both the Western and Northern theaters, while the Eastern Air Command in Shillong is responsible for the Northern Theater. The Army Central and Eastern Commands look after the Northern border, while the Army's Northern Command is split between the Western and the Northern borders. In total, there are 17 commands responsible for guarding against India's traditional 2 front borders. The IAF had raised objections to the previous theatrization plans, stating that it would divide their fighting assets. Over the last 2 years, multiple studies were carried out by top officers of the 3 services to examine the theaterization process, which lost pace after General Rawat's death. According to officials, the services were asked to individually study and check the feasibility of adopting a new and separate approach to the Indian military's theaterization plans. Defense officials say that with a national security strategy in place, it will also need a higher defense organization and interface between the government and the military leadership. HDO has to reflect the whole of government, the whole of nation approach, because it is nations that fight wars. The HDO will not be only of the Defense Ministry, it has to have the representatives of all ministries. Once decisions are arrived at, the armed forces are free to do their job and all the other coordination must be carried out by this organization. This is Anjana signing off. Do like and share this video. For further updates, subscribe to Community Global.